the next thing we're going to add that I'm going to walk you through is adding a finish line. The way we're going to add a finish line is the exact same way that we are going to add anything static. So as you look at the requirements, you may be asked to add an enemy, something that would hurt, you know, our character. You might be able to ask to add things that help your character, or things your character needs to collect. Anything we want to appear at a certain spot in our game, we're going to code the exact same way I'm about to show you, even though all I show you is the finish line. The rest of this, the process is the same. So what I am going to do is come down to the bottom and paint a sprite. I'm going to use the rectangle tool to do quite a bit of this. So what I'm going to end up doing is kind of like a flagpole, okay? And then the programming on the flagpole can be pretty easy. So I'm going to adjust this to get a brown color that looks like a wood post. And if you want, you can use the outline tool, or you don't have to. It's your choice. In this case, I'm not going to, because I want to use either this color or my flag color and have my character come into contact with it. So I'm going to use the rectangle tool. Zooming in is a good idea. And I'm going to start this at the base and make a pole. The nice part is you can see it out here, even though it's floating up in space. If you want to, I can go ahead and grab it and bring it down so that I can see what my, you know, what my sizes look like with my character. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make a triangle-shaped flag. So I'm going to change my color back up to full brightness. I'm going to go over to like a purple. Now, as weird as it may sound, I'm going to draw this as a rectangle. I know you heard me say I want a triangle-shaped flag. However, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this tool right here that's reshape. And then when I click on the shape, I can click specifically on that dot and delete that dot. Now I've got a three-sided shape. I could also have added curved or other points to make other shapes. So this gives me a flag, and I can zoom in a little bit more and make sure that everything lines up the way I want it to. And I'm going to use a yellow circle, nice golden yellow. It's kind of a ball on the top. If I hold shift, that'll make a perfect circle. And as you can see, I'm going to make it at least as wide as the pole and kind of put it on top there. I'm going to go ahead and click the pole shape and make that a little narrower just so I can have my little finish flag. And again, if I wanted to, I could use my text tool and put finish or end on it. I'd probably want to brightness, no saturation, get down to a white. Type out the word finish, grab my pointer tool, decrease this, and put it on the flag. Again, do you have to use the text? No, but it's kind of fun to do that if you want to do that, to give yourself a finish line or an end line or whatever you want to call it. Okay. Now what I'm going to do once I've created it is I'm going to code it. Okay. So what I want to do is I am going to build two stacks. So I'm going to kind of start building them at the same time. So I'm going to bring out my two when clicked. Both of them are going to use a forever loop. So I'm going to grab forevers. And one of them is going to use an if-then. So I'm going to go ahead and drop that in the second one. Okay. Now I'm going to work on the first. This is the one that's going to get it to show up where I want it to show up. And I'm going to go first to looks. And I am going to change the layer. So I'm going to tell it to, and this is as clicked, I'm going to send it to the back layer. And what that does is as I move this up and down, I hit the green flag. You can see that post is behind that layer. So that's what it means to go to the back layer. Okay. Now, the next thing I am going to do, because I believe it'll stay with me, and I'm going to go in my game all the way to the end. I'm going to get to where I want this. So now I'm going to position this. So it's right there. It goes just ever so slightly into the ground. Again, that's just to give me a little bit of guidance. And I can see right now that that Y is 83. So I'm going to grab motion. And I'm going to say go to X and Y. And that Y is negative 92. So that's where that is right now. I'm going to just change 92 to 82. It went up some. So yeah, this is the way I like it. So I can even, as I bring my character up, I know that whatever color I choose to use as my contact color for winning, I can touch that. Whether it's the goal, the yellow ball at the top, the purple flag, or the post, okay? And remember, that color should not exist anywhere else in your game. So make sure you pick something unique. Now for X, I don't want it to just go to that position, because again, now it's just following along, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I noticed when, is I'm gonna have to kind of guesstimate this. So I'm gonna actually go back to it and go back to the end. I shouldn't have gotten out of that yet, but I'm gonna go back to the end. Okay. And the hard part is normally what we can do is if we wanted this to be like right here, I know now that this is 1829, okay? And if I go until I get to 1920, which is right about here, I'm so super close. And then I look at my X, if I take 1920 plus this X, that gives me a good estimate to start at. So my X value is going to be, I need the plus operator. I need the scroll X variable. And I am going to say that it is scroll X 1920 plus 25. So that gives me 1945. Okay. Not negative. I know this is negative, but we're adding it. Okay. So we're going to put that right there. Okay. And the other thing we're going to do is we're going to forever add that to tell it to go to that place and to show. Okay. While I'm here, I'm going to grab the hide one because that's going to go over here. And since I'm here, I might as well grab it. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do sensing, and then I am going to tell it to touch the edge. Because I've now connected it to scroll X, okay, first off, you see it's not there. Okay. What it is it's basically over here touching the edge, which is why it's currently hiding. And then if I go and I go all the way to the end, you see as I come in, there it appears. And now I can come up and make contact with it. And if I go away, touches that edge, then it hides. Okay. And if you want to make that a little smoother, you could potentially add an ever so slight weight in there, a quarter of a second kind of weight right there. And that might smooth that out a little bit as it disappears either way. So feel free to mess with that as you want to. Again, this is the exact same for adding anything that I want in a static place. Okay. You've seen some other things that I have moving around. Those have additional code in this forever loop that follows this that has the motion there. That's really all I removed from that. Again, the thing that you're going to have to mess with is where exactly is this position? Because I didn't really care. I just kind of wanted it on the top of this little ridge. If you have this that you want it in an exact position, you may have to mess with this number to get it to be exactly where you want it to go. And that's really it. That's how you add static elements into a game that is a side scroller.